friends. Welcome to Fridays with the Ranger. I'm Ranger Shannon with Lewis and Clark National Historic Trail in Omaha, Nebraska, and I'm very glad to have you joining me. I'm enjoying a sunny spring day outside our visitor center since we're still closed. I'm actually sitting outside in our River Critters environmental play area on top of the beautiful stone-carved statue of the piping plover, one of many wonderful birds you can see along the Missouri River. I thought it'd be a good place to sit since birds are part of our topic this week. However, we're not just covering any bird. We're covering one of my favorite birds and one of the birds I find most interesting, and I hope you do too, from the Lewis and Clark Expedition of 1803 to 1806. So let's get started and learn all about the common poorwill. Do you know what an adaptation is? An adaptation is a change that living things make in order to better suit their environment. As the seasons change, what are some adaptations that you make to better fit the changing weather conditions in your environment? Some questions to think about are,
what do you wear to go outside when it's raining, snowing, or really hot? Do you use a heater, air conditioner, or fan indoors? How does your body react to weather changes? When do you sweat or shiver, and what else does your body do?
As you think about your own adaptations, let's explore one of North America's sleepiest birds and learn about some of their adaptations.
A common poorwill stands on the rocky, sandy ground at night. The common poorwill, otherwise known by its species, Phalaenoptilus natali, is one of 9 members of the nightjar bird family. They have black, gray, and brown-toned feathers, a short beak bill with a wide mouth, large eyes, and short, rounded wing and tail feathers. Captains Meriwether Lewis and William Clark use a map and compass to find their way during the journey west. The expedition spotted a common poorwill in North Dakota on October 16, 1804. They stumbled upon it as it appeared to be sleeping. Captain Lewis remarked in his journal, "A black and white illustration of a nighthawk perched on a tree branch."
This day took a small bird alive of the order of the manuscript left blank, or goatsuckers. The Rickeries call this bird tona. Its note is ata tona, ata tona, tona. A nocturnal bird, sings only in the night, as does the whippoorwill. Captain Meriwether Lewis, October 16th, 1804.
Wait a minute. Goatsuckers? Why do you think Captain Lewis called them that? This is because, in ancient folklore, it was believed that the common poorwill and other members of the nightjar bird family came out at night and sucked the milk from goats' udders. This, however, is completely false. Common poorwills don't drink milk. They eat bugs, like grasshoppers, beetles, and night-flying insects, such as moths. They have large, beady eyes that allow them to see better in the dark, at night, when they are most active. They have their wide mouths, which allow them to eat bugs up to 1.5 inches long. They also use their mouths to scare off predators, in which they will crouch down, spread out their wings, and hiss with their mouths open.
A nighthawk on the ground in its defense position. The way you can tell a nighthawk apart from a common poorwill is that common poorwills have a white band around their necks and down their chest, as well as on their tail feathers.
Common poorwills tend to live in dry, arid climates, such as deserts.
A common poorwill nestled in between some rocks in Death Valley, California.
They also live in rocky habitats with scrubby cover, dry woodlands, and dry grassland areas throughout western North America, Canada, and northern Mexico. Something interesting to know about them is they don't build nests and they don't live in trees. Common poorwills will nest on bare, open soil, gravel, rock, or sometimes even in rocks.
A common poorwill resting and closing its eyes on top of some broken branches and dried plants.
They will also often live in secluded rock shelters. Their earth-toned feathers help them blend into their environment so that predators can't see them. This allows them to sleep without worry of being harmed. They can also go into their state of torpor, which we'll get into now.
A common poorwill in torpor nested on a rocky outcropping.
Known as hochoco, or the Sleeping One by the Hopi American Indian tribe, the common poorwill uses something called torpor to survive extreme weather conditions, such as droughts, wildfires, and very cold temperatures. Torpor is similar to hibernation, in which animals lower their breathing, body temperature, and heart rate to conserve their heat and energy to survive. However, the difference is it's actually a sleep-like state that can last minutes or several weeks at a time. Hummingbirds also use torpor for just minutes at a time.
A close-up of a hummingbird fluttering around with its beak in purple wildflowers.
But the common poorwill is the only bird in North America known to do it for long bouts of time. Torpor does have its drawbacks for the common poorwill. It can take them several minutes to wake up, in which they will shiver, and they will have slower reaction times until they fully wake up, which makes them prone to predators. I hope you enjoyed learning all about the common poorwill today. Be sure to share some of your adaptations in the comment section down below, and to learn more about the common poorwill and even do a fun common poorwill coloring page, be sure to check out the description box. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you again soon. Bye!